When the HP Reverb G2 came out, they marketed it as the no-compromise headset. In my review, I found that it was not true. While I loved the display so much, I called it the king of clarity. The lower field of view and especially the controller tracking let me down, which was sad because it was almost the best VR headset of that year. But now, they released a new version of the G2 with improvements to controller tracking, eye relief for better field of view, improved compatibility with SteamVR, performance upgrades and better support for AMD. So basically they are fixing the biggest complaints most other people and I had with the headset. Now, HP loaned me a review unit, so I'm about to share an updated review. Why now, since the new version was out already in the US for a few months? Well, it's only since February that it's also more widely available, like in Europe and other countries. So join me beyond reality right after a message from today's sponsor. Bulky wallets are of the past. You just need a wallet by the rich. It's slim, lightweight, and still fits up to 12 cards plus room for cash. So carry less, but always have what you need. What I like the most, it's made of military-grade materials for durability, so that it will last a lifetime. I did some testing myself. It's also guaranteed by the rich team with a lifetime warranty, and they are so confident that you're going to like it, you get to try it yourself for 45 days. By then, if you still think, nah, then you can get a full refund. This is the carbon fiber one, but they have over 30 variations to choose from, and I think they all look awesome. I guess I know what's in your next travel bag. Click the link below and get the 10% off with our coupon code. The rich wallet would have looked nice with the G2 as well, if only it was standalone. But I digress. The specs of the HP Reverb G2 are impressive on their own, and so unfortunately that is not currently possible as a standalone headset. You need a gaming PC to run it. Most of what I said in my first review still stands, so I'm not going to go through everything in detail again. I recommend watching that review after this video, if you haven't yet, link is below. Today, we'll just focus on the improvements. Now, most of what I said in my first review still stands, so I'm not going to go through everything in detail again. I recommend watching this review after this video. If you haven't yet, the link is below. Today, we'll just focus on the improvements. But very summarized, I thought the HP Reverb G2 is a solid headset overall. Great value for the specs at $600. It's currently also on sale. If you buy it directly from HP, how long the deal will stay, I don't know, so don't wait too long if you're interested. The display is still amazing, aside from some little things that were quickly forgotten when immersed in VR. That hasn't changed. One thing I could not get around was the field of view that was lower than most other VR headsets. And that's why that's one of the things HP improved. The headset now has a new face gasket with a removable spacer that enables users to adjust their eye relief distance. With the spacer on, the eye relief distance is about 15 mm, and with the spacer off, the distance is significantly lower at 9 mm. If you wear glasses, you may need the spacer to make room for your glasses, but if you can remove it, it improves the field of view and the sweet spot, which is noticeably better. The field of view was this and is now this, and it's actually a night and day difference compared to the previous facepad. And when I'm setting the strap really tight, I do see the edges of the display, but it's certainly better than the FOV of version 1, where it looks like you're looking through binoculars. So this update pretty much voids what I thought about the field of view before, since it's a lot closer to other VR headsets now, and it looks great. Pretty amazing. You are also amazing, but only if you smash that like button. The next improvement is controller tracking. The first version had a lot of trouble tracking the controllers when occlusion happened and there were blind spots below, on top, and in front of the headset. HP said that this upgrade, and I quote, significantly boosts the headset's tracking capabilities, increasing vertical tracking volume by 30% compared to our original headset and resolving blind spots above and below the waist. HP added hardware changes to the physical camera module on the new Reverb G2 unit, so this does not work with version 1, something to keep in mind. Now, it's hard to test the tracking volume exactly, but I tried it, and indeed the tracking range on top and below the headset is better. Especially playing Beat Saber on Expert, I found I am not losing tracking as much even when making fast movements. Same for grabbing stuff on my belt in a VR game, only if I start looking for it, I can cause tracking loss, but overall, it's noticeably better. The tracking range left and right of the headset has always worked well, so no complaints there. Unfortunately, the front of the headset is still a blind spot that didn't change. I still lose tracking when I hold my controllers close to my eyes while wearing the headset, like when I use snipers. I also tested the tracking in different light conditions, bright and dim, and it's been a stable experience. I'm not sure if they changed something here too, but I remember I lost tracking often enough to find it bothersome, but now it doesn't happen or so occasionally that it doesn't bother me. But the tracking was already okay for a casual player like me. However, now I like it even more. I still think it isn't ideal for certain types of shooters or when you play very competitively, but I would say it is good enough for most games and other use cases. The last physical improvement is a new improved cable with better AMD support. I cannot test this because I use Nvidia cards, but for those who do use AMD, they say the new cable resolves connection issues that some users experienced, and if you already have the G2 version 1, you have the option to buy this cable separately. The last updates are software based, which means it will also work for G2 version 1 owners if you are on Windows 11, that is. These updates are only for Windows 11 and they are made mostly to streamline the experience for SteamVR users and improve performance. This is very welcome as this headset needs a beefy computer. As you can see, you need a nice graphics card to run the HP Reverb G2 at full resolution. And even if you have one, the Windows Mixed Reality software that you had to run next to SteamVR took up a lot of unnecessary resources. Well, in my opinion, Microsoft probably thinks otherwise. This is just not great as most people use SteamVR as it has the most VR content. So thankfully, HP and Microsoft listened and included a new environment built for performance for the Mixed Reality Portal. You can find it in the pins panel within the Places menu, and there are also a couple of new settings that you can access by clicking the three dots at the bottom left and then settings. One allows you to skip the Windows software entirely and start SteamVR straight away. Yay. And you can also set whether you want the Mixed Reality Portal to start up at all. And it does indeed seem better this way. I used to have occasional crashes for some reason, but after turning the WMR software off and motion smoothing as well, just a little tip, I haven't experienced a crash yet, so it's been good. Now, aside from these improvements, the rest of the specs haven't changed. It's still the same. So if you want my thoughts on all other specs like comfort, audio, display quality, etc., etc., then check out my previous G2 review to get the complete review of this headset. The link is below. So with all these new improvements, I would say this is the best value PC VR headset on the market right now. Yes, the tracking is still not as good as the Quest 2, but it comes close, and software-wise, Microsoft could still improve, but with the added field of view and them solving the most annoying complaints, I truly think it's a great headset. I like it. Certainly, it is the headset with the best looking display for the best price. It throws the Valve Index off its throne for me, but honestly, the Index is also just outdated now. What do you think about these improvements? Are you looking to buy this headset now? Let me know in the comments below and also why. Now, if you want to buy one, you probably want to make sure you get the right version, as it's possible that certain stores still have the first version in stock. Unfortunately, there is no sure way to see what version you're getting just by looking at the box. Even looking at the headset, design-wise, nothing much has changed when comparing version 1 with version 2. Of course, this isn't great, so I reached out to HP about this, and if they have a better way, I'll update it in the comments and description. For now, I recommend calling the store you want to buy it from and asking them, or make sure you have a good return policy before purchasing. In any case, I really appreciate HP for listening to their customers, and I hope more companies will follow their example. For now, this is it. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate you. I will not be here without you. So big love and a special thanks to all my champions VR on.